Reloaded, everyone. Welcome back to Dead Space. This is Argonoth, and yes, it has been quite a while. I am sorry about that. I work a retail job. Yes, that is my beautiful face in the corner. You can see it once again. I don't know if I've done any of the Dead Space playthroughs yet. I did get a haircut, and yes, I do miss my longer hair. But let's go to Chapter 5, Lethal Devotion. Ooh. See what this is all about. You guys have a good Thanksgiving? I did. I went to Tennessee. Very nice.
Isaac, I can smell the contaminated air from here. It's spreading faster than I expected. I'm trying to isolate it, but it's not going to buy us much time. We have to get that thing off this ship. The chemicals you need are in the chemistry lab. I'll hack the door for you when you get there.
Looks like someone has reprogrammed the door locks on this deck. And recently, too. I guess we're not alone here after all. Someone doesn't want you in this part of the ship.
Thank you.
us to the chemistry station. Once you get the chemicals, you're also going to need a DNA sample of the alien tissue. I'll search the records for one.
I now have a live subject for my study. I'm eager to validate my tissue regeneration. Initial restraint was problematic, but now the patient's resting comfortably. He trusts me, Dr. Kind. He puts his life in my hands. He knows his part in all of this. Understands what I'm doing. The forehead has been swabbed clean and marked.
What are you doing with that?
I'm now attempting to create a passage to insert the sample tissue into.
I absolutely hate this part coming up. So I'm looking at for you. Biggin right there? Yeah. That dude right there. He's immortal. No matter how many times you shoot his limbs off, he don't care. You can explode him, shoot him off. He doesn't care. Yeah, it might take a second, but he will regenerate his limbs. And he will come back. And you have to outrun him. And then put trap him. So, give me a moment. I'm gonna do a little montage.
Your fight for survival is admirable, but pointless. And yet you keep on going. It almost makes me think that we had hope as a species. And we're the only one who sees that we have died out a long time ago. We just haven't accepted it yet. Stop running. Stop your struggle. Our future. Your future, the future of our race, ends here. Allow me to introduce you to humanity's child, the children that will replace us, our greatest creation.
Now you need to find a DNA sample of the growth.
Home safe.
According to lab records, there's an inert sample stored in the ICU. A Dr. Mercer was apparently doing intensive research on it. I've been trying to contact Hammond, but all I'm getting is static. Isaac, you've got to hurry.
Persistence surprises me. Holding on to your final breath, you claw your way along. The whole world was once your world, but now belongs to the children. Be glad of the knowledge that your death will bring their birth. Listen, can you hear it? It's coming. Say your prayers.
All's good. I almost dropped something. We're good. Planet Cracker Starship Ishimura. Poor Isaac was only sent to do the communications. Like, to fix it. And that's it. Here he is. Alright. So, for the sake of, sake of your eyeballs, peepers, I'm going to go ahead and edit past this till I'm screaming again. Maybe. I might be screaming. But I'm gonna get back to the part where I was. And...
Someone keep shutting down the door protocol. I bypass the lock. Go!
You're so fucking
Thank you.
respond well to my experiments. Its cellular fortitude, not to mention elasticity, is remarkable. Dr. Kine, I'm sure, would disapprove. But I do not anticipate that issue, as the good doctor is busying himself with the marker. As if that matters now. He has also succumbed to the same dementia that afflicted the colony. Only yesterday, he told me he had spoken to his wife. But Amelia Kine has been dead for some years. My subject grows restless. Patience. Your time is soon. Very soon.
He succumbed to the dementia. What about you guys? Where'd you go? Some people don't know.
Adding sample 9797 to chemical compound. Final mixing required.
That's it, Isaac. Now you just need to...
This has gone far enough. Accept your part in the God's plan. Embrace your own extinction.
Warning. Life support system failure on medical deck.
What the hell was that?
Please evacuate immediately.
Isaac, he's decompressed the entire deck, and I'm being locked out of those systems. All the air has been vented into space. You should be able to bring it back online from the security station, but you don't have much time.
You need to make the poison. Now get back to the chemistry lab.
What are you going to do? Do it fast. Can I be breathing?
You're cutting out, Hammond. I'm gonna try to switch over. Shit. I lost his signal. I'll continue scanning for his location. You have to get that compound mixed.
And I will. God.
I've got more intel on the atmosphere. A survivor's report says a massive creature entered the hydroponic deck from outside the ship. That's when the air quality began degrading. The survivor called it the Leviathan.
But not too lucky.
Processing request. Please stand by. Final mixing complete. Please remove the capsule.
Let's hope that poison works. Head back to the tram station and get up to hydroponics as fast as you can. Still no response from Hammond, so be careful. There's no telling how contaminated that deck is.
I'm beginning to truly admire your spirit, misplaced as it may be. I think you should see the whole plan. You should not spurn the hive mind's offerings. You deserve to witness that, at least.
Perhaps now you would understand. The work I have done must continue. Will continue. I, Dr. Charles Mercer, shall serve as a catalyst to the salvation of our species. These specimens will return to Earth with me. I will spread their divine glory across the entire planet. I will leave you with my creation. Embrace the inevitable.
The last we see of that thing. I've managed to override Mercer's lockdown. There's a secondary tram station nearby, and you can take it to hydroponics. Let's just hope there's enough time.